This is the weirdest fucking story I've ever covered on this channel. This man removed a woman's body from her grave and kept her for 7 years. Carl was a radiology technologist in the 1930s at a hospital in Florida. On April 22nd, 1930, Carl met Maria, who was checked into the hospital at the time. When he met her, he instantly fell in love. It was more of like an obsession, but Maria later died in 1931. In 1933, Carl dug up her body and took her home with him. He claimed that her spirit would visit him at his house and tell him to do this. He attached her bones together with piano wire and gave the corpse glass eyes. This guy's lost it. Once the skin started to badly decompose, he replaced it with silk-soaked wax and plaster. He then stuffed her body with rags so she could keep her shape. In 1940, he was arrested, which means he had her for 7 years. Seven. Carl was charged, but then the charges ended up being dropped and he was released. Whenever he was released, he made a life-size doll of her, which there's rumors saying that he actually went back, dug up her body again, and then replaced it with the life-size doll. This is what Netflix didn't tell you about the Night Stalker, Richard Ramirez. Obviously, he's a bad person, but they left out all of his childhood. Richard was born on February 29th, 1960. When he was 12 years old, he was highly influenced by one of his older cousins, Miguel. Miguel was a veteran, and he would tell Richard all of the terrible things that he did overseas. He would often show Richard photos of women that he raped, and he would also show him pictures of, like, women he was sitting next to, decapitated. He would also teach him military skills, which would include killing with stealth. A 12-year-old. So yeah, this guy was a real piece of shit. In 1973, Miguel shot and killed his wife in the face right in front of Richard. So after this, Richard moved in with his sister and her husband, Roberto. Now, this guy was a fucking creep. He was a peeping Tom. He would often take Richard along with him to, like, spy into women's windows and that kind of thing. So not long after this, Richard started experimenting with drugs and Satanism. And that's basically how Richard grew up. Richard is no doubt a monster, but I feel like if he was raised better, things could have been different. This mysterious death doesn't make any sense. On June 7, 2017, 19-year-old Tanner kissed his daughter goodbye and told his mom he would be back in about 30 minutes. He was going to go hang out with a friend. The friend he was going to see was one of his newer friends named Jeremiah. Unfortunately, Tanner never made it home. After Tanner didn't make it home, his sister Kelsey went to go find this Jeremiah kid's house. Once she got to the apartment, she knocked and no one answered. So she opened the door and the apartment was absolutely trashed. It looked like the apartment had been ransacked. There was couches flipped over, but there was one thing that stood out to her, and that was Tanner's baseball cap. He didn't go anywhere without it, and it was just sitting there. Kelsey then took the hat to the police, but they just acted as if he was a runaway. They didn't really care or put too much time into this case. About 2 weeks later, while still looking for Tanner, Kelsey actually runs into Jeremiah. One of the shocking things is Jeremiah was actually wearing Tanner's shirt, and not just any shirt, it was the shirt that he went missing in. I'm sorry that's all the time I have, but part two will already be posted to my page. Part two of the sketchy death. When Kelsey saw Jeremiah, she confronted him about the t-shirt and they eventually just both went down to the police station. The police tested the shirt and then also did a voice stress test on Jeremiah and it came back with some level discrepancies. About 6 months after his death, something horrible happened. Two kids who were walking to school reported a body hanging from a tree. It was confirmed to be Tanner. The body was badly decomposed and his feet were missing. His death was eventually ruled a suicide, but his family did not buy that. People would send the family a ton of tips, and a lot of them were saying that he definitely did not commit suicide, that this was murder. A construction worker came forward and said he had been at least 10 feet from that tree multiple times within the year, and his body was not hanging there. Another person also came forward and said that they walked the trail 2 to 3 times a week, and they never saw anything. However, the police said his body was high up, so it could have been missed, but I definitely don't buy that, and his death is still ruled a suicide to this day. His own mother checked him out of school and he's been missing ever since. What happened to Timothy Pitson? On May 11, 2011, James dropped his 6-year-old son, Timothy, off at school. However, just a little bit later, James' wife, which is also Timothy's mom, came back and checked him out of school. However, James had no idea about this, so whenever he went to go pick up Timothy from school, the school was like, "Hey, your wife picked him up earlier." James, who was obviously confused, then reported both of them missing because he had no idea where they were. On May 12th, there was footage of Amy and Timothy standing in line around 10 a.m. at a water resort in Wisconsin. And then around 1:30 p.m., Amy made several calls to family members claiming that they were safe and nothing was wrong. Around 7 p.m., she was seen on footage again in Illinois, but this time she was alone. The next day, she was found overdosed on pills in a motel room, but Timothy was nowhere to be found. However, when they found her body, there was also a note claiming that Timothy was safe and he was with people who cared about him, but he would never be found. To this day, there's still no sign of Timothy. This is a picture of Timothy and that this is an age progression. Have you seen him? This guy broke into a home of a family he was stalking and lived there for 2 months without them knowing. In 1986, Daniel started taking interest in a girl named Annie. He got her number from a phone book and then started calling her and talking to her frequently. Daniel described himself as good-looking and athletic and kind of talked himself up to Annie. Daniel finally asked Annie out on a date and she agreed. Whenever they finally met, Annie realized that Daniel kind of misrepresented himself and was lying. So that date obviously didn't go very well, and when he asked her for a second date, she basically just said, fuck no. So this really pissed off Daniel. So not like any normal person, just taking the heartbreak, he broke into their home and found a crawl space and lived there for 2 months. He tormented the family by doing random tappings around the house, which really scared them, and then leaving mysterious writings on the walls, and they had no idea where it was coming from. Until one day, Annie's father went into the room, and that's when he found Daniel. He found Daniel wearing a wig, a dress, and then he also had a hatchet in his hand. He ended up attacking the father, but the father got away, and then Daniel got arrested. He ended up getting released, but that's not the end of him, like for part two. This is part two of Daniel, who broke into a home of a family that he stalked and unknowingly lived there for 2 months before he got caught. If you haven't seen part one yet, make sure you go watch it. So once the father finds Daniel in his daughter's room, they fight, and then he gets arrested. Daniel gets put into a juvenile facility, and then in 1987, he was released. Literally, not even a month later, after this idiot is released, he breaks into another woman's home, and she was a pregnant school teacher. He raped her for several hours and then shot her in the back a couple times. He then drowned both of her children. After this, Daniel fled to a few towns over. This guy is just ruthless. So when he gets to this next town, he tries to kidnap a woman in her car, but luckily she gets to escape. 2 days later, the police find him hiding at a dumpster and he's arrested. While he was in custody, they found a hair on his sock and it was linked to the pregnant woman that he killed, Abigail. A year later, he was then sentenced to 3 life sentences. In 2017, Daniel asked for a resentencing, and basically after this, the judge was just like, fuck no, you have no remorse. Daniel will